Hello guys, my name is Aman. Today in this video I want to show you a 3-minute game that I played online. So I am white and my opponent is a Russian player with 2051 rated, so pretty good rating at least for me. So I mean to defeat I should say. So yeah, e4, e6, he played the French defense. If you know me, I will always play e4. So d4, d5, I takes, and then c3, nf6, bishop e3, bishop e7, queen d2, castles, and I mean opposite side castles, and pretty interesting to play. So although exchange variation, but I think I try to spicy up the game. So b6, f3, just taking away the e4 square and also preparing g4, h4, h5, and preparing the pawn storm, and bishop a6. I think bishop a6 is a very clever move. I mean, if for example if bishop f5, then I can play always. I mean, I can always gain some tempo on the bishop, and he cannot put on any other square. I mean, any other good square. So I think exchanging is a very good thing because I can always. Oops. So yeah. I can always have this move bishop to d3, and this bishop will be very good on aiming at h1 square. So that's thing. And after h4, I think I should have played more of g4 at first, just taking away the h5 square, because I think now knight h5 may have been possible, although knight g2 is good. Yeah, takes, and c5. Yeah, if I takes, and although he has this hanging pawns, but I think d4 is coming pretty soon, and I have to face issues, so I just simply played g4. But I think, yeah, I was looking at knight g2, but the problem is he can always play c5 c4, and then I think he can also sacrifice p5, I guess. So I just played g4, and after c takes d4, bishop takes d4, knight c6, and obviously I cannot play the natural bishop e3 because of d4 and pinning and forking. So I thought, okay, let's just give up that bishop and play knight g2. Here rook c8. Yeah, he thought it rook c8, and then king b1, knight takes d4, bishop b4. And yeah, here I think I should have taken with the queen because of the bishop b4 move. So like, now I think he had this d4 move, and the idea being if queen takes, knight takes, he can always take, and he can always collect this pawn. I think he can even play knight d5, and yeah, if instead knight takes, then I think bishop takes and c takes, and I think he has pretty decent compensation, especially the knight blocking, and I mean now there is an absence of b pawn, so I think he has some pretty good compensation. And yeah, but he just took on c3, and I took with the knight, and after d4, yeah, here I think I should have played knight b5, but he thought, okay, let's exchange these knights and go into a major piece and late end game or middle game or end game. So I played here knight e4, and after knight, I think here simple knight b5 would have given me a very good advantage, and knight e4, knight takes e4, f takes e4, rook e8, and yeah, I think here I should have played, but rook f4, I think, because rook e1, and I mean, right now my rook is doing nothing, but at least on f4, it not only protects the e and g pawn, but also it would have put some pressure on f7 by maybe doubling on f5 or placing my queen, and I don't know, something like that. So queen d7, attacking the g4 pawn and g5. So I can always protect, but I think post pawn should be my opposite set castling, so pawn storm should be pushed. So I thought of g5, rook cd8. Yeah, I don't know what is the meaning of this move, like rook cd8. I mean, I'm not attacking this pawn, he's not putting some pressure anything or pressure on anything. So why to play rook c d8? I mean, I don't know, maybe something like rook to e6, with, I mean, like, for example, you can always double on either on c file or e file, I don't know, something like that. But yeah, and I played h5. Yeah, I played h5, sorry for the black screen. And after rook e5, attacking my pawns, so I played queen to f4 and queen e6. Yeah, I just wanted to have my queen on more on active square, because I'm right now not able to attack this pawn. So why to put my queen on a passive square? So why not put on f4, and so that at least I can have something like this. So I played queen f4, and after queen e6, yeah, he's protecting laterally as well. So g6, and he played h6. I think this is more of a mistake. I don't know, maybe he can play something like, I don't know, maybe rook e8, I'm not sure. But yeah, h6, and I took. And yeah, the problem is he cannot take with the queen, because his rook will be hanging, and king f8, and rook hg1, d3. Yeah, I mean, at the end of the line, I'm having some back rank issues if my both rooks move. And but now with d3, he's helping me. So after d3, c takes d3, and rook takes d3. Now at least my king is, whenever he checks me, I can have an escape for square on c2. So I play rook g6, queen e7, and here I think I played rook takes e7, but I should have played rook takes h6. Yeah, my idea being if king takes, then I have this check, and whenever he goes back, I have a mate on g8 if he goes to f8, and not only f8 but also if he goes to h8, then I have this pawn push queen and or knight check, something like that. So that's the thing. And after king takes g7, rook g1 check, here I should calculate more of, I don't know, what would have happened after rook g5 check. I mean, I have this strong passer, so that's the thing. At least I would have perpetual. I calculated that, so I was okay. And after king h7, yeah, here I played f8 knight check, because there is only one square for the king, and queen takes h6, and after queen to h7, then queen takes h7 is checkmate. So he has to give up his queen, and after takes again, I'm threatening checkmate on g8 and g7 squares. So he has to give up, interpose his queen, rook to g5, and after takes, and this is a matter of technique. I mean, I finished off. I'll just show you that in the end position, and that's it. So yeah, I mean, yeah, here I think rook takes h6 is a kind of a mistake, I should say. I think rook takes h6 would have given perfect shot, because he has to take, and then queen takes h6 and check, and king takes, rook check, and yeah, let me see that. Yeah, this is the line. Yeah, so yeah, I was calculating rook takes h6 and rook takes c7, and I thought rook takes c7 is a blunder. I mean, not a blunder, but a mistake. I mean, rook takes h6 would give me immediate chance, and I don't know why suddenly I played rook takes c7. So it's happening pretty much lately. So yeah, that's it. I hope you like this video. So please subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and thank you for watching, and have a good day.